On this day, November 27, 1989, triumph of nationalism. Rafael Leonardo Callejas and the National Party swept away the opposition in the general elections. This was the most impressive victory of the National Party, electoral of the 20th century. According to the final results, Callejas won the presidency over his liberal rival Carlos Flores Facusé by 50.9% of the votes against 43.1% for Flores. It was like, in 1990 it happened, the peaceful transfer of the leadership of the ruling party to the triumphant National Opposition Party, an event that had not been repeated since 1933. During Calleja's presidency, more than 12,000 Nicaraguan Contras based in Honduran territories were expelled, this after the electoral defeat of the Sandinista regime at the hand of the opposition. Likewise, it is worth noting the favorable judgment issued on September 11, 1992 by the International Court of Justice in The Hague on the dispute with El Salvador over the jurisdiction of 420 square kilometers of border territory in the Gulf of Fonseca, which involved the surrender to Honduras of three-quarters of the disputed area and the confirmation of its coastal arm in the Pacific Ocean. Also, during his administration, the United States made cuts in military aid to Honduras, which went from $41.1 million in 1989 to only $2.7 million by 1993. Once the Cold War ended, U.S. politicians began to see the Honduran military not as an ally against communism, but as a corrupt and costly obstacle to the country's democracy. On the economic front, Callejas faced the difficulties of other governments in the area in implementing financial stabilization and structural adjustment measures following the IMF's precept, a momentous undertaking that he launched, confident in the popularity he enjoyed as a new president. Callejas' priority objective was to resume dialogue with multilateral credit agencies 1 year after the World Bank declaration of Honduras as an ineligible country for the disbursement of new loans. This was a day in the history of Honduras.